Hello students, in this video we will study about kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera consists of eubacteria and archaebacteria. Bacteria are the sole member of this kingdom. Here we start with kingdom Monera. Monera is the kingdom of microscopic unicellular prokaryotes. That means their nucleus is primitive type, not well organized. Genetic material found free in their cytoplasm. There are certain characteristic features of Monera group. They are microscopic, unicellular and prokaryotic organism. They are cosmopolitan, that means they found everywhere and every type of habitat. They also live in extreme habitats such as hot springs, deserts, snow, etc. They lack nuclear membranes. Mode of nutrition is absorptive type, but some groups are photosynthetic or chemosynthetic. Reproduction is mainly asexual by fission or budding. They may be non-motile or can move with the help of flagella. Next is the classification of Kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera consists of archaebacteria and eubacteria. Archaebacteria is a group of ancient bacteria or primitive type of bacteria. Eubacteria is a group of true bacteria. Eubacteria is further subdivided into bacteria and cyanobacteria. Some other groups of Monera are Mycoplasma, Rickettsii, etc. Here we start with archaebacteria. Archaebacteria is a group of special kind of bacteria that live under extreme conditions such as at extreme pH or at extreme temperature, etc. Few examples of archaebacteria includes halophils, thermoacidophils and methanogens. Halophils are those archaebacteria that live in habitats having high salinity and high light intensity. Thermoacidophils live in hot sulfur springs, and methanogens are found in guts of many ruminants like cows and buffaloes. They are able to produce methane gas from dung. So, methanogens used for the production of biogas. Here we start with eubacteria. This is a group of true bacteria, includes bacteria and cyanobacteria. Next is bacteria. Bacteria are group of prokaryotic unicellular organisms which is characterized by the presence of peptidoglycan cell wall, naked DNA in place of nucleus and mesosomes. This is a typical bacterial cell. Their cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan. Naked DNA is present in the place of nucleus. There is a free 70S ribosomes found in their cytoplasm. Membrane-bound cell organelles like Golgi complex, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum are absent in bacterial cell. Bacterial flagella is made up of single strand of protein, flagellin. It helps in locomotion. Next is cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria also called as blue-green algae. They are photosynthetic autotrophs having a pigment like chlorophyll A carotenoid which is similar to green plants. They are unicellular, conolial or filamentous, found everywhere and every type of habitats. The cell wall is two layered. The outer layer is made up of mucopolysaccharide and inner layer is made up of peptidoglycan. The cell wall possesses an outer sheath which is jelly-like and mucilaginous. They also form algal blooms. Red sea is so called because of the coloration provided by red-colored planktonic cyanobacteria known as Trichodesmium erythrium. Some of them able to perform nitrogen fixation, for example, Nostoc and Anabena. Bacteria and cyanobacteria both are prokaryotes. That's why they do not possess mitochondria, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum. Flagella are also absent in cyanobacteria. This is all about cyanobacteria. Thank you.